One of my cyber stalkers raises an interesting point, or at least said something that kind of tripped a series of thoughts in my mind with respect to this program. I mean, it's obvious that one of the goals is to try and get somebody labeled with a mental illness. But really, I think beyond that and leading up to it, it's to like overwhelm your mind, to prevent you from thinking critically. It's to basically just bombard you with so much bullshit and so much outlandish activity that I think the goal is to prevent you from being able to string a thought together or focus on anything of importance, to try and prevent you from looking at the world around you and piecing together what's going on. Because it's quite clear to me that I have a special talent for being able to see connections, look for deeper meaning in things, and read between the lines. And maybe some of the people that are on this list that are being targeted have that ability as well. And that would be very dangerous for, you know, people, a cabal that's doesn't have humanity's best interest in mind. People who are perpetrating lies, huge lies, on the citizenry. If somebody could look at those lies and still determine what is going on. Somebody who doesn't buy into those lies and looks deeper and looks at it, takes a global look, a global view of what's happening in the world, and draws conclusions on their own, and doesn't necessarily let the news media and the puppets that are being fed information draw their conclusions for them. And so maybe we're seeing an uptick in this because they're accelerating their plans, or, you know, it's a critical time in their plans. And there are various people out there who aren't going to accept the lies, the big lies that are being told to them. And they're going to be able to piece things together on their own. And they fall outside of the agenda. They're not working within the system. They're not part of the system. Therefore, they're liable to tell the truth and warn others about what they think is going on and make them think critically about certain events, certain stories, and the direction that our society is headed. So if you had a group of people out there like that that were a threat to the powered elite, perhaps they would want to target them with this program. But even if they can't get a person to suicide themselves, commit suicide, even if they can't get that person arrested on bogus, trumped-up charges, or set them up, and even if they can't get them psyched through a civil commitment proceeding and out of the way, removed from society in that way, if they can't remove somebody from society one way or another, the program would still be beneficial in terms of distracting and preventing a person from spending the kind of time necessary to focus on what's going on around them and put these things together, figure out the pieces of the puzzle, and warn people preemptively about what might be coming. It's weird because a long time ago I met a girl at a party or something, and I guess she was in the field of neurobiology, cognitive science, clinical psychology. She was like a grad student. Her project was to see if they could overload a person's mind, similar to you would overload a computer's random access memory. If you overload the random access memory, the computer shuts down, it slows, and basically crashes. I think it's interesting that this program tends to look like that. It seems like it has benefits, even if the other professed goals of this program aren't successful. At the very minimum, what they're able to do is start to overload a person's mind and take valuable computing power away from problems, away from situations, problems, events that might be occurring in the world, and get them to apply it to this problem to distract them, to overload their mind. And, you know, I think with enough of this, you might be able to eventually just get a person to crash. And I guess that's one of these goals. When a person crashes, that's when they committed a crime that'll allow them to be arrested, or, you know, act in a way that will allow authorities to, you know, put them on a 72-hour lockdown where one of their corrupt psychologists can then slap them with a mental disorder, drug the shit out of them, and then perhaps commit them against their will. But before that happens, before that crash occurs and a person, you know, loses it or breaks down to a point where they can be neutralized by one of those methods, it's still diverting computing power away from, it's taking resources away from areas that it might be detrimental for the power elite for that person's mind to be focusing on. So you're basically wasting human resources that might be applied, mental resources that might be applied towards looking at this problem in an objective fashion, and you're overwhelming that person with outlandish activity, just things that are unreal, in order to divert their attention away from that which is important. There's the conundrum, because what they don't realize, what these people don't realize, is by doing this, by perpetrating this crime against citizens, it kind of tips their hand a little bit. It allows people, it actually becomes the issue. It becomes the most important issue, because it alerts people to the fact that there's something seriously wrong in our society, that the power elite has to devote significant resources to diverting their enemies' resources away from looking at what they're doing, and instead looking at this distraction, at this problem that they're creating, this outrageous behavior and activity on the part of the network that they've developed to harass citizens. So it actually becomes part of the peace. And by looking at it and looking at what they're doing objectively and trying to analyze what the motive, what the purpose of it might be, you come to the conclusion that it is part of the problem. It is part of the system. It is part of what they're trying to divert your attention away from, which is their evil and the planned totalitarianism that they're ushering in. It basically demonstrates the fact that, yeah, we are living in a totalitarian nation. And people who think a different way, who have those special skills, who aren't being manipulated, aren't able to be manipulated to such a high degree that they end up becoming a mindless zombie who can be spoon-fed information and conclusions, where people who think critically have to be attacked because they're not going along with the totalitarian agenda. So really, in trying to divert people's attention away from what they're doing, they demonstrate what they're doing and what the plan is and where this is all going. So it becomes a piece of the puzzle. Yeah, I'm disappointed that I can't spend more time looking into those areas that truly interest me, and I have to spend my time focusing on this and worrying about how I'm being targeted and trying to counter those attacks and analyze what is occurring instead of, you know, looking at a news story, you know, looking what's going on elsewhere. That doesn't really affect me. But in a way, it's kind of good that it affects me because it makes me fight that much harder.